A year to remember, Erskine Boulevard residents congratulated seniors from all South Bend area high schools with signs, banners, music, and balloons as the 2020 graduates paraded down the street. Plus,
with no money coming in, it's hard to not only pay your bills at home, but pay all the bills here.
It's time to reopen for some businesses in Indiana, and here at home, barbershops are ready for customers. See what you need to know before returning. And COVID-19 in the White House. Learn the precautions President Trump's team is making as close members of his team test positive for the virus.
From our bedrooms, basements, and living rooms, it's Michiana's number one homebound student talk show, Buzz in the Bend.
Hello and welcome to Buzz in the Bend, Michiana's award-winning student talk show. I'm Alex Almanza from Riley High School.
And I'm Bernardo Malone, also from Riley High School.
Bernardo, to think that technically our last day of school is next week, how you feeling?
I'm feeling sad right now. It's just so crazy. I don't know how to explain it. But I'm kind of happy that school is going to be over next week. Because I don't have to get up anymore, and well, until I go to college at least. So,
yeah,
and there's some good and bad to it.
And we don't have to go all the way to June 2nd. That's pretty good news too.
Right.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it sure isn't feeling like the end now, but I mean, yeah. Think about it. Our last show is next week. I mean, how crazy is that? Our last show. Do you remember doing Buzz in the Bend for the first time?
Yeah. Our first Buzz in the Bend was, let's not talk about it, okay?
Yeah, yeah, kind of like our first Alan Big Mo show.
Yeah, definitely.
And like I said, it's truly not going to hit us until maybe a couple of days afterwards. Now, big announcement, we're going to try bringing back the Alan Big Mo show maybe a few more times, you know, to say farewell, and it's truly going to be a bittersweet goodbye. We'll be back hopefully this Thursday. I mean, what do you think, Bernardo?
Yeah, hey, let's get this show on the road.
Let's get this show on the road. Right, right. Well, thank you very much, Bernardo. High school graduates felt some love Saturday. Erskine Boulevard residents congratulated seniors from all South Bend area high schools with signs, banners, music, and balloons as the 2020 graduates paraded down the street. The organizer formed a committee and planned this in less than a month.
Clearly the word has gotten out the way we wanted it to, so we really just want a safe, happy event to honor our graduates. We kind of think that we would love for this to become an annual event.
Graduates from Riley, Washington, Rise Up Academy, Clay, Adams, Marion, St. Joe, and Career Academy all participated in the parade. It's time to reopen for some businesses in Indiana, and here at home, barbershops are ready for customers. The shops are open, but with changes put in place, making things inside a little different than you might remember. As the number of coronavirus cases across the country starts to slowly flatten out, more than 30 U.S. states have now eased quarantine restrictions. Here in Indiana, with Governor Eric Holcomb's Stage 2 Back on Track plan, restaurants can reopen dine-in services at 50% capacity. The plan also includes personal grooming businesses, but with a few added changes. I spoke with Ethan, a stylist at Denolf's Barbershop in downtown South Bend, and he says that he and his team have been working hard to ensure that the safety of their customers is number one priority.
You can only have so many people in the shop at a certain time, which with us being appointment only, we're not a walk-in shop, so there's not a lot of people waiting around. So we don't have to worry about that. We do have to wear gloves, which we've been doing already. And the biggest thing is that we have to wear masks, and the clients have to wear masks. We got rid of using brushes to clean our clippers and to dust off the hair off the cape, and we installed air hoses at each station just to help raise that level of sanitation.
With Denolf's barbershop being closed for almost 2 months, Ethan says that it's been difficult keeping up with payments on basic utilities.
We still have to pay rent, we still have to pay utilities, we still have to pay internet bills because we have to run our security cameras. With no money coming in, it's hard to not only pay your bills at home, but pay all the bills here. So not working for 2 months and receiving $0 is pretty tough. I just hope that people in the future think that it's socially acceptable now to wear masks, so that just to be courteous, even when regulations go away.
In South Bend, I'm Alex Almanza for Buzz in the Bend. An Indianapolis police officer fatally shot a young man on the north side around 6:15 p.m. last Wednesday, following a pursuit initiated by two members of the command staff that was captured, in part, on Facebook Live as thousands of viewers were watching. Several community activists and neighborhood organizers expressed outrage at what the video showed. SBS-TV's Bernardo Malone was in Indianapolis to capture the community's frustration.
Protesters filled up the streets here in Indianapolis, Indiana, and demanded justice after 21-year-old Sean Reed was shot and killed by an officer. Sean Reed, 21, was shot and killed by Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department around 6:10 Wednesday evening near 62nd Street and Michigan Road. A pursuit was started by IMPD Deputy Chief Kendall Adams and Chief Randall Taylor. Both were in unmarked cars and dropped out of the pursuit after marked cars joined the chase, which follows IMPD's pursuit policy, according to IMPD.
He was already down. He told them he was unarmed and they took my baby. They took him from us. He was unarmed. He told them that, and they tased him and shot him down. Ain't no justice for that. Ain't none. Boy, he was in the Air Force to be a cop.
We know there were comments, unprofessional and unnecessary comments that were made at the scene. So I will take care of the discipline with that.
What discipline? Hold on. Reporting in Indianapolis, I'm Bernardo Malone.
Last week, the press secretary for Pence and a military valet for the president tested positive for the coronavirus. Pence and others who were in contact with the coronavirus patients have since tested negative, but the virus can take days to incubate. The cases have heightened concern about the nation's ability to safely reopen.
One of Trump's personal valets has tested positive for COVID-19. Trump was informed on Wednesday that one of his valets has tested positive. The valet works very close with President Trump and would serve lunch, beverages, and other duties.
Know who he is, good person, but I've had very little contact. Mike has had very little contact with him.
The president, vice president, and staff have been getting tested daily since the news and continue to test negative for COVID-19. And Trump says he had very little contact with the gentleman. Even though the White House has not enforced stricter social distancing, many still do not wear face masks.
Testing is not a perfect art. No matter what you do, testing is not a perfect art. So we test once a week. Now we're going to go testing once a day. But even when you test once a day, something happens where they catch something. I've had very little personal contact with this gentleman.
Health experts know that both the president and vice president are very important, but are concerned that they are not taking the proper steps by quarantining themselves after being in contact with the person that's had the coronavirus. This has been Angel Hernandez reporting.
Another example of kindness seen here in Michiana amid the pandemic, David Saleh met up with volunteers of the St. Adalbert Church as they handed out hot meals to local residents.
On the west side of South Bend, at St. Albert Church and School, volunteers are eagerly helping feed over 100 families in the local community every day.
We are sons of God, and we on our hearts, we feel that we need to help the other people. We are here to serve.
The program strives to offer healthy fruits, vegetables, and hot meals to families of all age. And this couple has plans for when this is all over.
When this is over, we want to find another things to that we can help the community and the people in need. So we like to invite other people to do the same, to help each other as a community, help us in whatever we need.
Stay safe and just open the heart if you see somebody else who needs the food. Just come here around here in San Adalbert School, and we enjoy it.
With Buzz in the Bend, I'm David Saleh.
And there's plenty more to come on Buzz in the Bend. We'll be right back.
And guys, there's only one way out of this wedding. And Susan and John, because you so elegantly ripped off our show for your proposal, I feel like it's only fitting that you rip off the wedding too. So, let's rock. Well, we can't play this song unless you let me invite some of my family to the party. Ladies and gentlemen, the cast of The Office.
Oh my God. Oh my gosh.
Join me in the middle of ecstasy. Feel the melody and the rhythm of the music around you, around you. I'ma take you there, I'ma take you there. So don't be scared, I'm right here, baby. We can go anywhere, go anywhere. But first, it's your chance, take my hand, come with me.
It's like I'm waiting.
John and Susan, congratulations! Yes! Thank you so much for being a part of this. You're not only good sports and a beautiful couple, but you also represent all the other beautiful couples in the world who are going through the exact same thing. So we here at SGN are here for you, and we're here for them. Congratulations to all. Thank you so much. What a beautiful night.
Mad Max takes place in a dystopian Australia in the near future. It tells the story of a highway patrolman cruising the squalid backroads that have become breeding ground of criminals foraging for gasoline and scraps. SBS-TV's Zudane has more.
What a thunderous display of action is brought to us in the form of Mad Max. Set in the beautifully desolate dystopian outback of Australia, humans in the near future descend into war for God's nectar, that sweet, sweet oil. Such a landscape breeds outlaws of the nature of raping and pillaging, treacherous drifters with an aleatory lust for blood and destruction. The last symbol of hope in a hopeless world is the Main Force Patrol, a unit in which our dark hero Max is an outstanding force in. What follows is a straightforward tale of revenge, which gives me vibes of John Wick with its simplicity. Max is given a solid performance by a young Mel Gibson, back when he was just a closeted racist. Darn, darn shame. The practical effects used in this film were quite impressive for 1979. There was not one moment where I felt the techniques used were grossly outdated. Mad Max is a palpable cult classic that kicked off a successful franchise for generations to come. But through the lens of this global tragedy, can we see an eerie foretelling?
With COVID-19 bringing our world's economy to a grinding halt, panic buying is rampant, causing our supply chains to be shaken to their very foundation. The price of oil is tanking as a massive recession looms on the horizon. The masses are frightened and cling to their hopes. What shall become of this world?
Hopefully, a world with a rejuvenated sense of community, a world with more efficient global infrastructures in place, or maybe it would just devolve into an anarchic mess. Who knows? Some people just like to watch the world burn.
Mad Max, the maximum force of the future.
Now, before we end the show, take a look at your screen. A pair of police traffic officers in Las Vegas came to the rescue of a cat they spotted with its head stuck in a soup can. The Las Vegas Metropolitan Police Department shared helmet cam footage showing the two motorcycle officers stopping to help the cat. The video shows the officers catching the cat and carefully pulling the can from its head. The feline was able to run away without any apparent injury once freed from the can. I guess we can say the cat was fortunate that the officers came to its rescue. And that does it for this week's edition of Buzz in the Bend. Tune in next week for our final show, and we have a special surprise. Take care.